Hello everyone, I am Karif Agarwal. For my second video today, we're going to talk about the Supreme Court hearings for Judge Amy Coney Barrett in the U.S. Capitol and the town hall meetings between President Trump and former Vice President Joseph Biden. Our first topic today is on the Supreme Court hearings, which started last Monday on October 12th. They will continue to finalize these hearings and hopefully end, and the Senate will vote on, hopefully, next Thursday, October 22nd. Judge Barrett, over this past week, was questioned by both Democratic and Republican senators over various topics relating to current events. If confirmed to the Supreme Court, she will take the place of late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg and have a conservative 6-3 over the Democrats out of the 9th seat, which could be crucial in many decisions in the future. Through many readings, Amy Coney Barrett's mentor, as she said, was Antonin Scalia, who died in 2016, coming close to that presidential election. Many Democrats criticized President Trump's decision of nominating a Supreme Court nominee just weeks before the election. Let's see this clip from BBC. As we saw, that caused some major anger, but still the hearings are going on. And one of the key topics is the Affordable Care Act. Amy Coney Barrett's conservative nature added to the Supreme Court could change various things if Trump is reelected. In previous years, President Trump's efforts to get rid of Obamacare hasn't necessarily gone the way he wanted it to. The Supreme Court in the past did not approve of him getting rid of Obamacare. But if Judge Amy Coney Barrett is elected to the Supreme Court, then she might take a different approach and something might happen to the fundamentals of healthcare programs in the United States. When asked about healthcare in the Supreme Court hearings, Judge Barrett gave a very vague understanding about her approach to the Affordable Care Act and other healthcare programs. When asked about topics such as climate change, she gave a very subtle answer when asked about it by Senator Kamala Harris, as we see in this next clip.
And do you believe that climate change is happening and it's threatening the air we breathe and the water we drink?
Senator, again, I was wondering where you were going with that. You have asked me a series of questions like that are completely uncontroversial, like whether COVID-19 is infectious, whether smoking causes cancer, and then trying to analogize that to eliciting an opinion on me that is a very contentious matter, opinion from me that is on a very contentious matter of public debate. And I will not do that. I will not express a view on a matter of public policy, especially one that is politically controversial, because that's inconsistent with the judicial role, as I have explained.
As you saw from this BBC video, you can tell that she's been very evasive with many of these important questions. Analysis show that Judge Amy Coney Barrett has been one of the most evasive Supreme Court nominees. When Barrett was answering questions towards Democratic senators, she did not give that much of an approach as she did when she was asked by Republican senators. So, we will have to see what happens on October 22nd and if she's elected into the Supreme Court or not. Our next topic is on the Biden and Trump town hall meetings. President Trump, as we know it, has attacked Biden on several topics over Biden's weaknesses and statements. He attacked Biden on his calls about fracking, which are debatable. Besides his efforts to attack his opponent, Trump is still losing in national polls in key swing states such as Pennsylvania by around 13 points. But that is just a poll that we cannot rely on that much. Now let's move on to what Trump was asked on about himself at the meetings. President Trump's opinion over the COVID-19 pandemic and masks have been the same even though he contracted the virus not too long ago. When he told the reporter, Trump said that he knew that about the risk about the virus, but he did not want to panic the nation and saying everyone was going to die. But that wasn't necessarily true, and not everyone dies if they contract the virus.
Big threat. At the same time, I don't want to panic this country. I don't want to go out and say everybody's going to die. Everybody's
going to. Isn't there a middle ground? You don't have to mislead, but you can.
No, there's not a middle ground. You have to be safe, you have to be vigilant, and you have to be smart.
Now, after his statements over the COVID-19 pandemic, when Trump was asked about right militia groups such as QAnon, he gave a very demeaning response and said that he didn't know anything about it and only knew about left radical groups such as Antifa.
I denounce Antifa, and I denounce these people on the left that are burning down our cities that are run by Democrats who don't know what they're doing.
While we're denouncing, let me ask you about QAnon.
I just don't know about QAnon.
You do know.
I don't know. No, I don't know. What I do hear about it is they are very strongly against pedophilia, and I agree with that. I mean, I do agree with that, and I agree with it.
But there's not a satanic pedophile.
I have no idea. I know nothing about
that. You don't know that? Okay.
No, I don't know that.
One of his most controversial statements in that so-called town hall meeting was that he had done more for the African-American community than any other president, with the exception of Abraham Lincoln.
Mr. President, what will you and your administration do to better prepare our law enforcement officers to work in collaboration with the communities that they serve, and also to protect the lives of innocent Black and Latinos from police brutality and injustice?
Right. I fully understand the question, and I saw everything that you saw over the summer, and it was a terrible thing to watch. And some people don't like it when I say it, but a lot of people agree. I have done more for the African-American community than any president, with the exception of Abraham Lincoln.
What I don't understand about this is that President Lyndon B. Johnson, in the first 2 years of his presidency, conducted the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which forbade job discrimination and segregation in public places, signed on July 2nd, 1964. President Trump's statements can be backed up with information that says that that's not true. But that still did not mean that this election will not be close. The 2020 presidential election might be one of the closest elections in recent times. Let's see what happens on November 3rd.